Greetings, everyone. My name is Etterville, and welcome back to my Let's Play of Skyforge. During the last part, I completed all of the squad adventures in Glyceria. It's now time to pay a visit to Usuni Valley. For this province's bastion, I'll be aiming to get the piercing formation symbol. This'll allow my companion to inflict increasing amounts of damage to a target for the effect's duration. I'll only be able to use this once every 55 seconds, so this'll be useful for tougher enemies like mini-bosses and bosses. As this area's description goes, once serene, Usuni Valley is cut off from the world by the surrounding mountains. Invaders have ravaged the area, destroying towns and villages, causing the sky itself to become thickened with a whitish smoke. Residents have had no choice but to abandon their homes, fleeing to nearby regions for safety. The citizens of Usuni Valley look up towards their immortal protectors to use their magnificent power and put an end to these invaders. There are four main quest chains in this area: Trouble in Lixie, Demon Horde, Elemental Threat, and Chaos in Usuni Valley. In short, I need to help the Templars save the village of Lixie from the invading Vird and crazed wildlife, stop the demons and their corruption in the northern half of this valley, quell the disturbed elemental Wardens, and resolve the chaos brought to this valley by the three enemy factions invading and warring. The southern half of this area reminds me of the Lanber Forest, specifically due to the grassy plains and trees. Though, I'd say this area is visually more memorable because of the demon fortifications in the north, but we won't be seeing those until the next part.
The distress signal came from here. No other data. There are no Warden corpses. Look around the camp. I just scanned the area, but I wouldn't want to deprive you of your sense of importance.
In the valley's southern half, I'll be mostly dealing with the Virds and wild animals. In the valley's northern half, I'll be mostly dealing with demons. This is one of the larger open world areas to adventure in, so there's a lot to be done, 52 quests and to be exact. In fact, I'd say that Usuni Valley is larger than Viennis or Vines, the next open world area I'll be visiting in the future. Like with the previous open world areas, I'll be mostly silent throughout this part.
Dead this week. Resuming patrol. We hear strange noises at night. I'm looking for ground shake, as though something big is underneath. Garotis is scared and wants to go back to the village.
Like a good time to visit Lixie. Maybe we'll even see living people there. That was a joke.
May your light guide us. We need your help. A large demon troop attacked Cabrera. We lost all contact with the city 2 days ago. The situation must really be bad there. My men have spotted small enemy scout troops in our woods. The Reapers are already here.
Is that so? But that means we should expect an attack any second. We've never needed the help of the gods as much as we do now. I'll give you all information obtained by our scouts right away. One more thing. I know many would gladly follow a god into battle. If you wish to give our fighters a chance to do so, talk to Actionis. He is in the square, not far from here. I'm happy to see a god here. Sigmar has told me about you. Many of our fighters are itching to join the battle, but we need them here too. I've picked two of my best soldiers. So be it. I await your decision. We have a lot of volunteers. If you'd like to take another with you, come back anytime.
I asked for an archer over a melee fighter here because I wanted an ally who could actually contribute to most of the battles. Because of my relatively higher power level, I can easily dispatch of most foes before they come into melee range. Even if they do come in range, my character can shrug off most blows. If you're at this area's suggested might level and playing a ranged DPS class, I suggest recruiting a melee fighter to tank some of the incoming damage, especially once you get towards the north. These allies will always follow you around and assist you in combat. They'll still follow you around even if you teleport around the valley. They'll only despawn if you leave the valley, die, or they fall in combat.
Thank you.
objective. Proceed to the marked area on your map. I suspect they've already dined and had afternoon tea. You'll easily defeat them. Burrow detected. Your map has been updated. I advise you to hold your nose as you are approaching. Large troop of Reapers detected. Proceed to the marked area. The creatures will probably attack when you get close. Primitive biomass.
God, please help me. You're my only hope. This hole behind me appeared last night, and my son went missing. Could it be a coincidence? I fear the worst. The Reapers could have dragged him into their lair. We'd mine the burrow, but what if my son is in there? I hope he is still alive. Please find him, I beg you.
You should look around.
bridge leads to the town. It looks like the army of death is heading there.
Might be a good idea to establish surveillance on this route. I'm full of good ideas today, wouldn't you agree? I recommend focusing on other tasks. This monster can wait.
Thank you.
Your feat in Doramus is beyond words. Thanks to you, our lands are free of the enemy. Our people will not forget you, God. But there is still a lot to do. There are many problems in the valley.
Sigmaris is right with all of the problems left in this valley to address. I haven't even started dealing with the elementals and demons yet. So in summary, in this part, I pushed back the invading forces from Lake Sea and liberated Turimus from the Reapers of Death. That faction won't pose a problem here anymore. As such, the southern half of this valley has been almost cleared, bringing the completion rate up to 36%. In the next part, I'll strike back at the elementals and demons. Thanks for watching, and have a nice day. Toodles!